Good morning, all. Today I am discussing about the another theory in the motivation, second theory. So that is the Douglas McGregor theory. So this is also called as theory of X and theory of Y. So he divides Douglas McGregor divides this theory into two groups, two styles. That is, first style is the theory of X and the second style is theory of Y. The traditional styles of leadership and control stated in theory X by McGregor. Okay, so the traditional styles of leadership and control stated in theory of X by McGregor. So the normal traditional styles of the leadership is focusing on normal styles of leadership in the theory of X is exercised to managers on the basis of his assumptions about human beings. Okay, so this theory is mainly exercised based on managers and his basic assumptions. And also, managers also human beings. So he is not a, suppose the managers are also human beings. They are all not a, suppose they are, they don't have any supernatural powers or other things. So because every manager and employee both are human beings. And he is also considers the basic assumptions of the human beings. Okay, so in general, what are the basic assumptions of the human beings? Then he considered all the basic assumptions of the human being also. And these assumptions as laid down are observed by McGregor for theory X are. Okay, so these assumptions as laid down are observed by McGregor for theory X are. So, first one, suppose in simple manner, I'm elaborating this one. So, one of the group is satisfiers and the second group is dissatisfiers. Okay, so that means first group of the people are more, first group of people are having the positive attitude and also they are more motivated, so self-motivated. So we need not to motivate them. So in the second group, the people are having less motivation. So with force only, they are doing the work. Otherwise, they are not ready to do the work. Okay, so like this. So based on these characteristics, he divides employees or workers are into two groups. So in theory of X, an average human being does not like to work and he tries to avoid it as far as possible. So these people are... these people are not having any motivation, so they are also laziness. They are also having laziness. That's why an average human being does not like to work, because in general everybody should escape the work, but they want the money, whether they are working or not, but they are ready to take the salary and they want the money. So only for the sake of salary they are doing the job. Okay, so otherwise, there is no interest on this job. Okay, so just for the namesake and for the purpose of money, so only they do this job. So remaining all things are neglected by these people. So an average human being does not like to work and he tries to avoid it as far as possible. So how long it is possible, then up to that level, they are always trying to avoid the work. Okay, so this is the common human psychology, everybody. So only some of the people are having some hardworking nature. So the remaining majority of the people are having this type of quality. So he avoids accepting responsible and challenging tasks, has no ambition but wants security above all. Okay, so he avoids accepting responsible. Okay, so he is not ready to take the responsibility and also challenging tasks. Suppose there is any risk in that task, they are avoid the tasks. They are not taking the challenging tasks. And also has no ambition but wants security above all. So they don't have any ambition, but they want all the security. What are the mentioned in the previous theory? So physiological needs and psychological needs and self-fulfillment needs. So all they suppose these all these things or they want all these things, but they are not ready to work. Okay, so but want security above all. So they need above all, but they are not doing any work. Okay, so the psychology is like this. Then next point, third point, because of this, the employees are to be forced, concerned and threatened with punishments to make them put their best efforts. Okay, so because of this nature, the employees are to be forced by the manager, and also he gives some punishment to do the work. So after that level, then the employee's behavior is not changed, then simply the management is dismissed or remove that person from the organization. Okay, so there is some punishment or some force to do the job, to complete the task. Otherwise, they are not ready to work for the organization. Okay, so this is the another problem in the X theory. So then these people would not work sincerely and honestly under democratic conditions. So these group of people are not ready to work sincerely and honestly under democratic conditions. Suppose the manager is following some democratic nature. So then they are simply neglecting the manager. Okay, so because he is not give any punishments or something or any force, then the employees are not working. So this is a democratic nature. Suppose he is not giving any punishment and all other things, so he is not also forced. Just he simply said, the manager is simply said, try to improve your work, try to improve your work. So always he repeated it, but there is no use. Okay, so there is no use, the employee is not changing his behavior. Okay, so he is continuing the same behavior, the previous behavior. So however, the above assumptions are not based on research finding. So these assumptions are not based on the research finding. Okay, so the autocratic style basically presumes that workers are generally lazy, avoid work and shirk responsibilities. So for these type of employees, there is a leadership is a style that is autocratic leadership. Okay, so first one is the democratic and second one is the autocratic. So in the democratic leadership, the employees are not care about the manager. So because he is not restricting and he is not forcing the employee, so then the employees are trying to avoid the work. Okay, so but in the autocratic leadership, he just like he is behave like as a some type of dictator. Okay, so if they are not doing the work, then he will take the serious action on them. Okay, so basically presumes that workers are generally lazy. So in this category theory of X, Douglas McGregor basically in his assumption, these type of employees have some laziness. Okay, so and avoid work and shirk responsibilities, and always they are avoid the work, and also they don't have to take the responsibilities also. It is believed that workers are more interested in money and security. Based on these assumptions, the leadership styles develop. So but they are very much interested in the money and also job security. So they don't work, but they need the job security, and but they don't work, they need the money. Okay, so these are the basic assumptions. For these type of people, there is a need of some autocratic style leadership. Okay, so autocratic leadership, and insist on tighter control and supervision. Okay, so in this autocratic style leadership, there is a tight control and also there is a tight supervision. So the supervisor always focus on these employees. They are doing they don't do the work, and also there is a tighter control. So he gives He does not give any chance. The supervisor is not giving any chance. Okay, to escape from the work. So he continuously monitoring, and also he gives instruction. So you are not doing the work. So please do the work. Please do the work. Please do the work. So again and again, again and again, he keenly monitoring the employee. Then automatically they do the work. Okay, so in this way we have to mold them. Okay, through the punishments and also through tight supervision and control, then you have to control this type of behavior employees. Okay, so this is theory of X, that is a group, X group. Okay, so then next, coming into the second one, theory of Y. So these are the second group of people. So in this group, it focuses a totally different set of assumptions about the employees. So in comparison to the X group, there is a totally different assumptions for this theory of Y, that means Y group of people. Then very first thing is, some employees consider work as natural as play or rest. Okay, so this group of people are thinking about the work, it is natural. Okay, suppose we eat the food and we drink the water and we walk and something. So, and we talk with others like this. So in regular activities, what are the activities generally we are having regularly? The work is also, they feel the work is also like as a regular tasks which is done by him. Okay, so suppose suppose if you are eating the food just like that. Okay, so as like as they are also doing the work also like that. Okay, so some employees consider work as natural as play or rest. Okay, so that is the common thing in our life. So we must do the work, so then only we are getting the salary. So and also you feel very happy, so to complete the work, and also you have to have some satisfaction to complete the task. Okay, so this is one type of motivation, so they are having. Then second one, these employees are capable of directing and controlling performance on their own. So this group of people are having the self-control on them. So we need not to monitor them. So for monitoring or not, they are always do the work. So within that, suppose within the office hours, they don't waste the time of the organization. So starting to ending, so starting point to ending point, that means day one, day starting and ending. So suppose working are suppose 10 to 5, for example. So they are continuously working up to 10 to 5. So in normal breaks, they are taking normal break, lunch break and some natural calls. So for all these things, they are only spend the time. So the remaining time is totally put on work, and continuously they are doing the work. Okay, so there is no need of monitor or anything. Okay, so if you are monitoring or not, they are doing the work. Okay, so these employees are capable of directing and controlling performance on their own. So suppose they control their own performances, so we need not to control of the performance. They are having self control. Okay, so and also they have the capability of directing and controlling of performance on their own. Then they are directing and controlling their own performance. There is no need of another person help. So they have that capability. And then they are much committed to the objectives of the organization. So they take the total responsibility of their job, and also they are also taking the another responsibilities, so which are not assigned by the management. So with their self-interest, they are also involving the other things also. Okay, so then they are much committed to the objectives of the organization. That means employees are having some commitment, and so commitment to fulfill the objectives of the organization, because every organization has some objectives. So then the employee's duty is how to achieve the objectives of the organization. That is the one of the major important thing So because they are paying the salaries for the employees, so the employees are always try to resolve the issues. Okay, so then only the organization will be successful. Okay, so that's why there are much committed to the objectives of the organization. Okay, so so and they are much committed okay they are much committed to the objectives of the organization, and after that higher rewards make these employees more committed to organization. So then the manager duties, the managers are identifying those who are having the good performance, and those who are reaching the standard performance, and also they show the better performance, then the manager or management should give some awards and rewards to that employees. Then this gives some encouragement and motivation to committed to the organization. Okay, so the organization is take care about the employees, then they are also motivated, and they are also committed to the organization. Okay, so then you are giving the higher rewards to the better performed employees, then it gives some encouragement, and the employees are also felt the organization is recognized my hard work, then they are giving this opportunity. Okay, then given an opportunity, they not only accept responsibility but also look for opportunities to outperform others. So we are not only focused on the responsibilities of the employee, so we are not only consider the responsibilities, and also we are providing some opportunity to outperform others. Okay, so how their performance without any control on them, so then you have to observe that. Okay, then you have to understand the capability of that person, then based on this, then you have to continue or not. Okay, so that's depends upon your choice. Okay, so then there is opportunity, the employer, the management should provide an opportunity to outperform others. That means the employees are participated to give permission fellow employees to participate in the different type of activities, and also if there are any, suppose any sports or something, they know about the games, then you have to allow them. Okay, so then they feel some happiness in their minds, because the management is giving to this opportunity to me. Then they give some encouragement to the employees and also students. Okay, then most of them highly imaginative, creative, and display ingenuity in handling organization issues. In this one, most of them highly imaginative. So in this group of people, most of the people are imaginative. So creativity and display ingenuity, so in handling organization issues. But one of the problem is they are not handling the organization issues in a proper manner. So, and also they have some creative and display some ingenuity in handling organizational issues. Okay, so this is about theory of why. So this is the theory of X and Y, that is Douglas McGregor theory. So next and last one. So this is also one of the important thing. So Hertzberg's two-factor theory of motivation. So this theory is proposed by the Hertzbergs. So he divides the motivation theory into two factors. So in 1959, Frederick Hertzberg, a behavioral scientist. So he is a behavioral scientist. A two-factor theory. So a two-factor theory. So are the motivator hygiene theory. So this is also called as motivator hygiene theory. So according to Hertzberg, there are some job factors that result in satisfaction while there are other job factors that prevent dissatisfaction. Okay, so some job factors are resulting to satisfaction, and some factors are giving some satisfaction to the employee. So some job factors are giving some dissatisfaction to the employee. So this is also based on satisfaction and dissatisfaction. So according to Hedberg, the opposite of satisfaction is no satisfaction, and the opposite of dissatisfaction is no dissatisfaction. Okay, so according to the Hedberg, the opposite of satisfaction is no satisfaction. Okay, so he considered satisfaction for a suppose of a satisfaction and a dissatisfaction. So satisfaction means opposite word of the satisfaction is no satisfaction. In general, satisfaction and dissatisfaction, that is the antonym. But according to the Hedberg, the antonym of the satisfaction is not satisfaction, and the antonym of dissatisfaction is the no dissatisfaction. Suppose if there is any dissatisfaction, the management should try to, there is no dissatisfaction. Okay, so but the satisfaction, there is no satisfaction. So that means if there is a satisfaction or no satisfaction. Okay, so then Hedberg classified these job factors into two categories. Okay, so Hedberg is classified these factors into two categories. So one is hygiene factors. Okay, so second one is motivational factors. Okay, so hygiene factors and motivational factors. So what are the hygiene factors? So hygiene factors are those job factors which are essential for existence of motivation at workplace. So some in workplace, there is a need of motivation. It is essential. Okay, so essential for existence of motivation at workplace. Okay, so then they do not lead to positive satisfaction for long term. So they do not need lead to positive satisfaction for long term. Suppose we are not continuing for a long time, suppose positive satisfaction for a long period. So after some time, then they feel some dissatisfaction after some time. So it is only possible only some of the years. So after that, there is some negative satisfaction. That means they don't satisfy. So it leads to negative satisfaction. So, but if these factors are absent, if these factors are non-existent at workplace, suppose these factors are not existent, these are not there. So then in other words, hygiene factors are those factors which when adequate, reasonable in a job, pacify the employees and do not make them dissatisfied. Okay, so in other words, hygiene factors are those factors which when adequate, so then at what time they are adequate, so then reasonable in a job and also pacify the employees and do not make them dissatisfied. So you are always focusing how to satisfy the employee, so and do not make them dissatisfied. Okay, so this is simple introduction. Then these factors are extrinsic to work. Hygiene factors are also called as dissatisfiers or maintenance factors. So then these hygiene factors are also called as dissatisfiers or maintenance factors, as they are required to avoid dissatisfaction. Okay, they are required to okay, so these factors describe the job environment. So these factors are describe the about the job environment and scenario. And the hygiene factors symbolized the physiological needs which the individuals wanted and expected to be fulfilled. Okay, so then hygiene factors also symbolized the physiological needs, that means biological needs, which the individuals wanted and expected to be fulfilled. Okay, so in needs which the individuals wanted and expected. Every individual is wanted or expected to be fulfilled. So hygiene factors include, what are the hygiene factors? One is pay. Okay, so first one is the pay. The pay or salary structure should be appropriate and reasonable. So based on the work, based on the performance, you have to give the money. So pay to the salary. So it must be equal and competitive to those in the same industry, in the same domain. Okay, so the pay or salary structure should be appropriate and also reasonable. And it must be equal and competitive to those in the same industry, in the same domain. Suppose the other company is giving same domain and same product. So they are giving the high salaries, but you are giving the low salaries. Then there is a comparison in between these two organizations from the side of the employee. Then he considers all the things, then he takes the decision. Okay, so then this is pay related issue. So company policies and administrative policies. So company policies and administrative policies means the company policy should not to be rigid. Okay, so the company policy are always very simple, and they don't have some we are not using the rigid. So they should be fair and clear, and also they should be fair and also clear. So it should include flexible working hours, dress code, breaks, vaccination, etc. Okay, so it should also include the flexible working hours. So the company working hours about flexible working hours, and also dress code, and also breaks and vaccine and vacation. So you have to provide all the information at the time of the appointment, at the time of joining. So you have to clearly mention all these things. That is about called as company policy. And fringe benefits. So and the next one is the fringe benefits. The employee should be offered healthcare plans, benefits for the family members, employee health programs. So the management should provide a health insurance facility, that is Mediclaim. Then not only for him and also his family. So then he feels very happy. So and also feel very secure, having some security about health. Okay, so this is about these things. And next important thing is physical working conditions. Under hygiene factors, physical working conditions. So the physical working conditions are always very clean and neat. And also you have to provide some water facility and some toilets and all other things. Then the employee is also satisfied. So then suppose is there any hot heat in the organization, then you have to provide the ACs or some coolers or some ventilation. Okay. So then status. The employee status with the organization should be familiar and retain it. So the employee status, every employee should want to get some status in the organization. So then that is also one of the important thing. And the next one is the interpersonal relations. The relationships of the employees with his peers, superiors and subordinates should be appropriate and acceptable. So your relations, interpersonal relationships to the employees are very sensitive. So that is another important thing. So then the interpersonal relations also maintain. So then based on that, they are also following this one. They are also developing the interpersonal relationships. Then job security. So job security, it is very, very important. So the organization must provide job security to the employees. Every organization must provide some job security to the employee. Then only they are freely working. Suppose is there an uncertainty, suppose today or tomorrow or something. So the management is try to dismiss this person, then he feels some tension. So the remaining people also feels some tension, or they are not focusing on the work. That is also one of the plus for the organization. So then motivational factors. So according to Hedberg, The hygiene factors cannot be regarded as motivators. These factors are not related to the motivators. The motivational factors yield positive satisfaction. So the motivational factors always yields positive satisfaction. These factors are inherent to work. These factors are inherent to work. Okay, so motivational factors. The motivational factors yield positive satisfaction. So the motivational factors are always creating some positive satisfaction. So these factors are inherent to work. So these factors are generally inherent to the work. These factors motivate the employees for a superior performance. So these factors lead to employees showing a superior performance. These factors are called satisfiers. Okay, these factors are also called satisfiers. These are factors involved in performing the job. So then these are factors involved in performing the job. Employees find these factors instinctively rewarding. So the employees are always find these factors, and also they are rewarded. The motivators symbolize the psychological needs that were perceived as an additional benefit. Suppose they are having they need some psychological needs also, then they are more motivated, and also they are additionally benefited. Motivational factors include recognition. So everybody must need some recognition. So in the organization, the employee should be praised and recognized for their accomplishment by the managers. The employee should always try to some recognition and some praise from the employee manager. So the manager is also should practice this. Suppose is there any good performance of the employee, then he definitely praise that person, and also give some reward to that person. Then sense of achievement. So the employees must have a sense of achievement. So every employee must have some sense of achievement, suppose regarding the achievement, why, what they are achieved and what purpose they are achieved. This depends on the job. It is purely depends upon the job. There must be a fruit of some sort in the job. Okay, so it is nothing but it's like a fruit. So then we are getting the fruits after success. Then that is important. So then growth and promotional opportunities. The employees are also focusing on growth and also promotion. So in growth in the job and also promotion, then you have to provide that one also, then they are also felt happy. So there must be growth and advancement opportunities in an organization to motivate the employees to perform in. So the management should focus on growth and promotional opportunities, both are providing. Then the employees are motivated and also they do well. And responsibility, the employees must hold themselves responsible for the work. So this is totally related to the personal. So if the person are ready to take the responsibility, then they are only taking the responsibility. Otherwise, nobody is taking the responsibility. So he has some commitment to take that responsibility. So the manager should give them ownership of the work. Okay, so the manager should give them ownership of the work. Okay, so then they should minimize control but retain accountability. So they have minimized control and also, but they have some accountability. And next one is a meaningfulness of the work. Suppose if you are doing any work, there is just some meaning of that work. Suppose without any meaning or without any reason, you can't do anything. So because it's a waste of time. So the work itself should be meaningful, interesting and challenging for the employee to perform and get motivated. So the work has some meaning and also interesting and also challenging, then the employee to perform well and also is motivated. Okay, so this is about theories of motivation. Okay, so up to this, fourth unit is over. So from Monday onwards, I start fifth unit, that is the last unit. Okay, so that's it. Thank you.